and welcome back to my channel. And yeah, happy new year, by the way. I know I'm late, I'm sorry. Anyway, I had the most amazing trip for New Year's Eve because I spent it with friends in Budapest. So yay to those of you who guessed it on Instagram. This was the prize. Well, I must say, Budapest actually surprised me, and if you have the chance, you should definitely visit it because it's totally worth it. As you might have guessed from the name of the country, Hungary, there are lots of delicious foods that made my journey incredibly pleasant. But I think it's about time that we switch to linguistics, so here are 5 facts about Hungarian. Yes, Hungarian with an H. Fact number 1. Hungarian is spoken by 13.6 million people, which makes of Hungarian the most spoken non-Indo-European language in Europe. However, only 9.5 million speakers are currently living inside Hungary's borders. So you can actually bump into Hungarian speakers in Slovenia, Austria, Romania, Vojvodina, that is the region of Serbia, the Slovak Republic, and Transylvania. So yeah, if you happen to meet some vampires and don't understand your Romanian, you should definitely try some Hungarian. Fact number 2. As was mentioned, Hungarian is not an Indo-European language. In fact, it belongs to the Finno-Ugric branch of the family of Uralic languages, just like Estonian and Finnish. During its history, Hungarian acquired influences from Iranic languages, German, Slavic languages, but in particular from Latin and Turkish languages. The first scripts in Old Hungarian were actually written using runes that were very similar to the runic scripts used by the Khazars, and for a couple of centuries, linguists debated whether Hungarian belonged to Turkish languages or Uralic languages. Latin alphabet was introduced around the year 1000 when the Kingdom of Hungary was founded. From that moment to 1836, Latin was the sole official language of Hungary, while Hungarian was left for everyday use. During the 18th and 19th centuries, Hungarian underwent a linguistic reform in order to standardize it and make it more suitable for sciences and literature. So in 1836, it became official language alongside Latin, while in 1844, Latin lost its status as official language and Hungarian finally became the official language of Hungary. Now that we're talking about national pride, I should probably mention the fact that when I was little, I used to mistake the Hungarian flag for the Italian one, so I guess I've been Hungarian for a while. Does that count? Fact number 3. Hungarian is an agglutinative language, which means that words are made up of a linear sequence of morphemes, and each morpheme contributes a piece of meaning to the word. In a simpler way, we could say that words are composed of a root that carries the main meaning of the word, and to that root we can add pieces of word, and each piece carries one piece of meaning. In fusional languages like Italian, for example, these pieces of word can carry more than one piece of meaning, while in agglutinative languages like Hungarian, in order to add more pieces of meaning, you have to add more pieces of word. I will leave here an example. Hungarian, as many agglutinative languages, has vowel harmony, which is an assimilatory process in which vowels of a word have to be members of the same class, thus in harmony. Fact number 4. Hungarian has 18 case endings attached to nouns that increase up to 35 if you count the ones that are attached to prepositions. However, if you are considering learning Hungarian but this kind of made you shiver, don't worry, because it will become a lot easier if you think of them as something similar to English prepositions, but with the exception that they go after the word. Last but not least, fact number 5. Hungarian is a fixed stress language, which means that words always bring stress on the same syllable, in this case, the first one. A more famous example would probably be French, which always brings stress on the last syllable. Hungarian has 14 vowels, 7 long vowels and 7 short vowels. Acute accents indicate long vowels, while double acute accents indicate long vowels with umlauts. It also has 30 consonants, and some of them are written using 2 or 3 letters. So if you ever find a text with double consonants, consonants followed by Y, acute accents, double acute accents, and umlauts, you're probably reading something in Hungarian. I really hope you guys liked my video, and I really wanted to thank those of you who comment here on YouTube or DM me on Instagram. You because your suggestions are very, very helpful, and I feel like I'm learning a lot from you. And so I'm actually planning to share with all of you what I'm learning from this experience. So thank you very much, and please keep writing to me. I really hope to see you soon in my next video, which I promise will be sooner. Thank you for watching. Bye!